The cerebral cortex is composed of columns. The two levels hypothesis says that a column has high or low activity. The duration of high activity is around 450 milliseconds. Arrows indicate the relationship to the alpha waves. Colorful horizontal lines represent high activity in individual columns. The turnover of highly active columns is slightly uneven. The result is that the length of the alpha waves varies. Green symbols indicate an alpha wave pattern. The number of highly active columns alternates between a lower limit and an upper limit. The most common limits are 4 to 5, as in this figure. A regulating system keeps the number of highly active columns between the lower and upper limits. Signals from the regulating system are visible as alpha waves. It is a critical moment every time the number reaches the upper limit. The regulating system must react at once and reduce the excitability of the low activity columns. A mistake here can lead to a number that exceeds the upper limit. If the number is one step above the upper limit, it needs to be adjusted. The regulating system must wait until the activity in two columns has dropped from the high level before raising the excitability of the low activity columns. A problem may emerge if the regulating system fails and increases excitability when only one column has left the high level. In doing so, the number will exceed the upper limit again. Thus, the system may get stuck in repeated attempts to correct the number. The result is an epileptic seizure where the number of highly active columns alternates between the upper limit and one step higher. The regulating system receives information from all columns about their ongoing activity. The processing of the data needs to be very fast. And the system has to be extremely sensitive. There is a fine line between having sufficient sensitivity and having a sensitivity that is slightly too high. The latter opens up for mistakes, because the system may initiate a reduction in excitability before the activity in a new column has reached a high level. The system is then at risk of becoming trapped in a situation where the number alternates between the lower limit and one step lower. This seizure creates a characteristic pattern in the wavelength variation. The figure shows an example of such a pattern. Without an epileptic seizure, the wave pattern is difficult to find. Most often, you have to measure the wavelengths and draw a diagram. On the other hand, you can see the wave pattern at first glance when the number alternates between the lower limit and one step lower. The arrow shows where a highly active column is missing. It is easy to imagine how missing columns create the pattern. The duration of high activity is much shorter during generalized seizures. An expanded time scale is helpful if you wish to see the waves during epileptic seizures. The figure shows what it looks like when the number alternates between the upper limit and one step higher. The blue curve shows normal alpha waves. In this example, the number of highly active columns alternates between 3 and 4. The limits for the number and the actual number are the same. The red curve is from a seizure where the number alternates between the upper limit and one step higher. In the example, the limits are 3 to 4, but the actual number is 4 to 5. the regulating system got stuck in repeated attempts to correct the number. Strong signals from the regulating system create short waves. The green curve shows an example where the number alternates between the lower limit and one step lower. The limits for the number are 3 to 4, as in the previous two examples. But here, the actual number alternates between 2 and 3. The conclusion is that the two levels hypothesis can explain why generalized seizures occur. You can also say that these seizures verify the central part of the hypothesis. The turnover of highly active columns is delicate. The slightest mistake can lead to a number below the lower limit or above the upper limit. Therefore, epileptic seizures are not at all unexpected. We should be grateful that they do not occur more often.